The pit stops of the three stoppers. So who's first to go for the undercut?
I'm just loading up now. It's under pressure trying to get on. But keep going, Craig. Keep going. Oh, here we go. Lap six. Here we are. Here we go.
Lap six. Yeah, welcome, Malk.
El
Welcome to the
Fortuna.
action of the Spanish Grand Prix.
Thank you.
So I'm just following Lordy Boy at the moment behind Remco. As we see Big C in the distance just going round the final turn. Who is first to blink? Looks as if the top three at least are staying out as Josh pits. So we do know that there's a massive undercut at the Spanish Grand Prix, so could he get the jump on Remco?
Oh, Lordy Boy!
And Lordy Boy.
He's going for the dive bomb! Oh!
I'm missing it.
Oh! That would have been one hell of a move. That would have been one hell of a move, that would have been. Oh my god, don't do this again. Don't do that. Oh, that would have been some special move, that would have been. Oh my god, that what a way to introduce yourself to the live stream on this. Apparently the fastest lap is 30 seconds. That is impressive. I'm just trying to see if there's any other action going on.
Yeah, I'm just going through the grid myself. Josh has come out on the front tyre in 10th position. Jay Bentaleo behind him in the front tyre as well, followed by El Fortu on the option. Closely followed by Finest on the prime. And Ron Haig is in 14th position as Big C comes through the chicane section, sector 3. Will we see him fit? Looks to be through that quite gingerly, and he comes in for a pit stop. Now, the question is, Lordy Boy, that's a late entry into the pits there for Remco as in front of him, but the question is, where is Josh?
Josh is in 12th and he's just coming up to the chicane now.
So, will Josh get the jump on Remco and Lordy Boy?
I
certainly think the move that Lordy Boy attempted on Remco.
It was Big Sue, wasn't
it? Really cost them.
Oh, very cost them, my bad.
As Josh has come out in front of Lordy Boy, so
what a move.
Remco.
He's fifth.
So Josh has got the jump on him through the pit stop. He got the undercut. Remco just slightly ahead, so Remco and Josh are both on the prime tyre. Lordy Boy is opting for the options. So at the moment, advantage Remco on the prime tyre, the quicker tyre.
Do you think, what would be your strategy?
Sorry, Mal, Jay Bentaleo had a little look inside the time, thought he was going to make the move there, but he's got right in beside them, or behind him, should I say, getting his foot straight. They will have ERS coming up to the end of sector 2. Sorry, Mark, you were saying something in there.
Yeah, it was only a quick one about, you know, you were saying about the strategy now. Do you think the three options and then the prime is the best one for you in this stage now?
I think if you could possibly take the option tyre out to lap 7 or 8, which are, most of these guys have done, then I think the three option and then prime stand as well.
Yeah. Oh, okay. I'm just watching Lordy Boy. Should have DRS with Josh on the long straight. Oh no. Oh my god! Oh, what a move!
Yep, Josh left the inside open there and Lordy Boy just seized that opportunity. And now Jake is going to come under pressure from Lordy Boy on the option tyre. Jake is on the prime. I think Jake is yet to pit though, so his tyres will be starting to go off. Definitely looks that way. Lordy Boy is getting the job done and Jake very quickly. And Josh will pounce on that as well. But Josh will be doing a favour from Jake to let him by. So I'm wondering if Team Orders is going to come in here at McLaren. We're going, Dennis, be having a word with Jake, saying, Jake, you know about Josh is quicker than you. DRS open for Josh, and it looks as if he's got the move on Jake, but Jake won't find too hard there.
Oh,
so
Big C!
Jake go
Sorry, big C in there, and
sorry about
between first and second on the last chicane, coming into the last corner now.
Yeah, I think with this though, Aaron is on the prime tyre. He started on the prime tyre, so it's not really for position, because of course Aaron has to pit.
Oh,
but he's definitely doing Remco a favour by holding him up. Will Big C make the move to the inside? Will he do the Lewis Hamilton move?
I don't know.
Oh, will Aaron shut the door?
Oh!
That was a late... Oh, that was close. That was almost a remnant of Lewis Hamilton.
Jesus. No. Oh.
That one was certainly too close for comfort. Aaron was not willing to give up that place easily.
No.
Definitely on different strategies, but he was there for a fight. So a few heart and mouths moment there for Big C. But certainly that'll cost him time and possibly allow Lordy Boy to close the gap.
On that move.
I don't think you could repeat it on air.
That was beeping unbelievable.
Yes. As Tyndine has a little slide there, following Jay Bentaleo. Ah, oh, oh. Tyndine, look at the inside, look at the move done. Oh, I think he's thought better off, but just wait for DRS and try and avoid the contact and through the more technical corners. As Tyndine tucks in behind Jay Bentaleo, getting the slips, he will have DRS, definitely. I think then he moves to inside Jay Bentaleo. I don't think he's going to fight him too much. And finally gets a move done going into the front one.
That was a good move. A good move.
But it looks like Jay Bentaleo's actually come back on him a bit slightly.
You've fallen down the order to P15. Yeah, I'm just watching that now. I tell you now, it's one of them races where you just feel like your heart's in your mouth. You don't know when the next one's going to happen next on this track.
Well, it looks like it's coming a bit spread out at the moment. The gap from Big C to Lordy Boy is 6.1 seconds. I'm expecting Lordy Boy to close that gap down, being on the quicker tyre. So, as we'll stay with Lordy Boy to the start finish line, just to see the gap. As Big C says, quickest lap time of a 1:21.8.
I'm just watching.
So, I'm surprised, in fact, not. Apologies, Big C is on the option fire, coming from the prime. So, he's on a similar strategy to Lordy Boy.
Yeah.
So, at the moment, Lordy Boy and Big C are having a straight fight. As, oh, Josh had a slide coming out from the front two and goes into the gravel.
So what's just going to the pits now?
A bit out of outside its limits. It looks like Josh has actually got to move in Remco, because Josh came out behind Remco in the pits.
No, Josh was in front.
He undercut Lordy Boy, but Remco was in front of him, so I think Josh has got the move done in Remco. So Remco's down to fourth. And the gap between Josh and Lordy Boy is 4 seconds at the moment.
Oh, okay. That's
Tyndine tucking. He could get the move done on DRS zone 2, but he clipped the gravel, which will certainly compromise his straight line speed. Technical side, the Red Bull may have the advantage through this sector with a better chassis for Bankhorse, but Ferrari could have the better straight line speed. As Jay Bentaleo goes wider, that will certainly compromise his corner entry and overall speed. Tyndine will have DRS, can he get the move done? Again, because I believe Tyndine actually overtook him, so it may have had a little error which allowed Jay Bentaleo to take him back in. And allows a Sauber to come up behind as well. Oh, Tiny Dine puts the Red Bull on the inside of the turn. Oh, I thought he had that move done, but he possibly backed out of it. And that's allowing the wound of the Stroud, but it goes right in, and I believe the Toro Rosso. He feels that Ian could jump to them. I believe the Red Bull and the Ferrari are on the front tyre, and it could be the option. That is the option for the Sauber.
Prime again for fans. I think he's just coming out of the pits, I believe.
It looks as if Fowness is having a really hard race today. He seems to be really struggling. He's a look inside of the Red Bull. Oh! And he's just tucking right in behind J. Bentley on Tyne Dine. Even on the quicker tyre, tucks in behind the Red Bull. DRS and activation.
I don't know what's good there.
Inside, outside, inside, outside. What will it go in, out, and out? She got all the He decides better of it. He's certainly not going to risk his front wing. Well, the Ferrari
There could be three.
Jay Bentley looked to go off track there. It's hard to see from that angle, so I'm not 100% sure. It's Ewan Mizzle moving inside the Red Bull, but the Red Bull has it inside for the next turn. Could be contact. It gives him a little shove, but I think Ewan backed off and just tucked in behind, so very sensible racing from Ewan. He knew he was getting squeezed there by the Red Bull.
Bloody hell.
So very good wheel-to-wheel action here so far.
Ewan's gone!
I think he may have just saved the front wing.
That Almanavis just passed him on that. That was just unfortunate.
Yeah, I think Ian's looks as if there was an element of lag during the race. Yeah. It looks as if there's a few cars glitching. But it looks as if Ian's front line is still intact, but he's certainly going to pressure the nav for ninth.
Remco's just gone past Josh for third place. After the couple of first turns. Trying to see if there's any other action going on. But Josh, so I ain't giving up. I look right close then to Remco's car. We've got Fannis behind Warren Haig. There's not much. Oh, you got Aaron and Manav. I think there was a collision with Manav and Aaron. I only saw a glimpse of it. I don't know if you've had a call of it.
I've just joined Aaron now. It looks as if he's lost a place to Jake, so I'm speculating there has been an incident which has caused Aaron to drop a place to Jake, but it looks as if he's got front wing damage. He did. Yeah, I think he's lost his end plate. So there has been front wing down. Yeah, that's a big slide from here, and he's certainly losing the downforce at the front. Although he was able to save the front wing in the last instant, he's certainly more this time.
Remco's just going to first.
Yeah, it looks like a big seat is pitted. He's pitted for the front tyre. And he's just behind Josh on the prime tyre also.
Josh could have a chance here. Split Mercedes. Stop the run. But it could be. Could not be, we never know. We'll have to find out on this. Could be not. This has been a fantastic race again, I think. Lots of, let's just say, close calls. Big C's right up close behind Josh now, to second.
Yeah, I think he's just going to line them up for the start-finish straight. Will Josh pit this lap? Possibly.
I know, because he's going for the corner.
Two laps. Oh, he's not waiting at all. He did look to cross the white line there, so you could argue that he may have to give that place back. It happened there quite quickly, so
yeah,
can't say for sure whether he crossed the white line, but it did look like he had.
Yeah,
certainly that's yours to decide if there is a vision there. But yeah, big scene, made them move on the corner. So at the moment we have a Mercedes 1-2. Both Remco and Big C are on the prime tyre. Remco will be on the older tyres. But I think if he overtakes Remco, he may be up a pit stop. Because I think Remco is yet to make his second pit stop.
What lap did he pit in? Do you know?
I think Big C pitted lap 8, Remco I think was lap 9. And as we see, Big C is just on the prime tyre, so he has made two stops. Remco has yet to make his second stop, and I believe Josh is the same also.
Big C's right behind.
Will he repeat last lap's overtake? No, I think he'll wait for, not, but Remco Burt is currently the pits.
Okay.
He'll go on the option tyre, but I think if this is Remco's second pit stop, as we see Josh as well, so Big C is theoretically a pit stopper.
Yeah. Unless dramatic happens, but you know, we can't say sure on that.
So as Josh elects for the option tyre as well as Remco. So at the moment we have Big C in first, followed by Robbie Boy, I believe 8 seconds behind. Remco in third, Josh in fourth, HD in sixth, Pindine in fifth, who are just coming out of the pits, as Jay Bentley takes fifth from Pindine. Facewift reply is having a battle with Manav going into turn one.
But Manav?
So it looks as if this could be a four-way battle between HD, Manav, Jake Warrior, and Facewift Reply.
Just watching that now. Facewift Reply, we should go try the overtake then on Manav on that short stride, but I don't know where all these yellow flags are coming from. But
well, all four of these guys are actually on the prime option tyre, so this is a straight fight between all four drivers, as Jake has a little Facewift Reply. Will he line them up for a DRS pass? I think he's just too far back at the moment. Oh, Jake looks to have got the better entry there. It will carry more straight on speed out of the corner. So we could see a four-way battle here. We will go with Manav first, just sitting behind the Sauber of HD, DRS and activation, and hopefully we'll pick up the fight between Jake behind. As Manav lines up HD, tucks him behind the slipstream, goes for the outside, and he's certainly got his nose ahead going into turn one, and it looks as if... Oh, HD coming back round the outside of turn three, Manav goes slightly off track. HD put his car on the inside line, and Manav hasn't covered off.
What's not HD's car? Sorry, carry on, Craig.
No, what you said, Mark.
I'm just watching from the Manav's car from behind. It looks like HD's car. It looks like he's lost his left front tyre. Like, but if you watch the stream later, you'd be, oh, HD is right close.
Oh, big moment there for HD. It looks like Jake is going on the outside. Will he get the move done? I think. Oh, Jake just get held off by Facewift Reply. As Josh sets the quickest lap time over, 121.4. HD closing right up behind Manav now.
Oh, Jake's got...
Jake Warrior goes right up behind Fist with the play as well. Jake making the move on HD. Fist with the play on HD, making the move on Manav. So two overtakes on the same DRS straight.
Yeah.
So far we're seeing a lot more overtakes than we did in the Spanish Grand Prix, but it looked as if Facewift reply was having a little look inside of Jake, but Jake hasn't covered up.
What do you think of the race so far, Craig?
It's definitely providing a good spectacle for us so far. With some good overtaking.
Yeah.
A few happening moments, a few big moments going on track. And possibly one or two incidents afterwards.
Yeah. Facewift reply has got a front left puncher. On my screen, he's got a front left puncture.
Oh, looks good at night.
That's weird.
He actually has DRS in effect. He's making the move on the inside of Jake. Yellow flags on track, so have we seen an off? But it looks like Manav and HD went side by side. Wheel to wheel action in turn 3.
Yeah, I think there's
as we have
there's a bug going on in this. Well, there is definitely a bug in this car amongst this game. Jake's and Facewift have got front left punchers, but in your screen you're saying that they haven't got it. Even HDE's got a front left puncher, but on my screen he's got lap 6 on stuck. As well as JP and Tina. The hell's going on? As we've been watching the fantastic race on this, just watching Big C, just passing the first second now, it's the first, Lordy Boy second, Little Remco third, Josh fourth, Titan Diamond fifth, just behind, like, trying to battle out with JB and Intel in the long straight, Manav sixth, Banner seventh.
As J. Bentaleo goes defensive there, Tyne Dine had made the move, but it went off track there on the left-hand side. But one thing I'm noticing...
Collision! Manav HD went to go for the corner on the first corner, but just clipped Manav's car, and he just went off the track. I would say that's more of a racing incident, because actually had the DRS and went for it, but he...
Well, we may see that in the stewards' office as well, so I might be having a late night.
Ah, okay.
Not just me, but also the stewards' office. But if you watch J. Bentaleo's line coming out of... just before the last turn, he seems to be really wide off the track. I'm just following at the moment, I'm wondering if we see a repeat there, if he's maybe just carrying too much speed. Yeah, he really flops with the white line on the edge of the track.
But he does get an exit.
He's definitely kept within the limits there, but there has been a few times where he has crossed the white line. So it's maybe just something to be mindful of.
Yeah.
And as it gets the DRS pass done on time thing. So certainly this looks as if it's going to be a race-long battle between the Ferrari and the Red Bull. As time thing seems to
be touched. I'm sorry to say there's any other battles going on. Not much going on. Oh! I've got one Haig running out with Josh, but
Nothing.
It's definitely not for position. George is actually lapped. Haig is looking to unlap himself. So it's definitely not for position.
Well, Joe Billington went wide again.
Big scene. Well, oh! Seen as well as.
Sorry, carry on, Craig. I'm just watching this battle.
I was just going from your reaction.
Sorry.
I was wondering what was happening.
Yeah, Joe Billington, nothing wrong. It's just Joe Billington went off, I can't remember which corner it was now, you know, the second sector, sorry, after the end of the second sector, third sector, you go left, yep. And then you go a sharp right before you get to the chicane. Mm-hmm. Joe Billington went wide just after the second sector and just clipped on Tyndyne. Which I don't know what's going on now, because on my screen he's like lost the front tyre, lost the left of the tyre.
Oh, the both cabs look very much intact with myself. But yeah, at the moment, Big C's opened up the gap between himself and Motherblind 6 to 12 seconds, with Remco 4 seconds behind Remco.
Who's impressed you the most today? Was that a hard one to ask?
Oh, contact between Ding Ding and Jay Bentaleo.
It's still going.
He's still got a front ring right enough, so the battle continues. I think Ding Ding just underestimated his breaking point, and he just certainly went into the back. I don't think there's any damage. Jay Bentaleo pits, so possibly looking for an undercut and opening up a gap between him and Tyndyne. I think Josh impressed me this race, certainly with his qualifying time, again in the top four, and his race pace.
Okay.
What about yourself, Mark?
I would agree with that, actually. He has done well, and he's nearly, as I say, nearly beat the Mercedes and the fast pace in Motorboy. But as we were talking,
Jake made the commander pressure here from Manal. I think Manal might just be too far back unless he tries a Bandai, which it looks as if he's going for. No, he decides better of it. But certainly still allowed himself to close up on Jake, so Jake may was that place on the next lap, and good evening to Hedge.
You're right, Hedge.
I believe it's just joined us. So welcome. Where have you been? You've missed some good action. Certainly the battle between Jake and the Nav continues. So I'll try and join that for the DRS start and finish straight. Big C has just exited the pits on the option tyre as Warren Haig unlaps himself. Remco has also exited the pit and he's also on the option tyre. And Josh is also exiting the pit on the option tyre. Time down pits for prime tyres. HD just come into the pit. Jay Bentaleo is going to possibly get a jump on time down here. But I believe Tyndyne was on the prime tyre and Jay Bentaleo is on the options. Yeah, he's definitely opened up a gap there with the undercut. So a wise decision from Jay Bentaleo the previous lap.
As I'm just watching Naughty Boy having a clear gap of Big C. Well, just under 10 seconds now, the gap. We've got Remco, and then Josh, Tyndyne, Manav, banning out with Jake.
As the just cutting to the race leader there, Malk, Lordy Boy, he's just coming up the pits. Tedge is asking a question, two-stop versus three-stop. What we're seeing so far is three-stop.
Yes. Three-stop is definitely the best option.
Well, Lordy Boy, keep his place to Remco, except Remco's got to jump on him. so the undercut there came into effect, so again, Mercedes 1-2. I believe the free stop is the quicker start strategy page.
But what tyres? I know we've discussed this again, but tyres wasn't there, so do you think the tyre option?
We are seeing two options.
Mm-hmm.
I think Big C is doing three runs and options, so that is possible, but you need to put your open tyre to lap 8.
Without?
Big C is provisional leader at the moment, Edge.
But, to be
fair. Andy.
Yeah.
Sorry, Malk.
No, I was just going to say, it's been a cracking race so far, but
it has.
Naughty boy, slowly catching up to
Remco. Yeah, just joined that. It may have DRS, which will inevitably get closer. I don't think it will have to pass this lap. Yeah, it just allows him to close up the gap between him and big Naughty boy. Finish on the option tyre, I believe this will be to the end. Five laps remaining of the Spanish Grand Prix. Looks as if HD may be putting pressure on Finish very shortly as well.
Oh, okay. I'm just still watching the Naughty Boy and Remco situation while you're checking on all the others.
HD's just closed right up in front, but he's went wide there. I think he's clipped the gravel. But he's certainly right up the back of Finus. So Finus may come under pressure here. I wonder if HD will make a move. He goes to the outside looking for the better pit exit. Oh, there's contact between him and Finus. And they're still side by side, wheel to wheel. Come on, the cameras! Some
sorry.
Of the camera angles are terrible! And Finus and HD are going wheel to wheel through sector 3.
Oh, just watch it now! Oh!
Oh,
yeah,
no. I think HD will probably get a move button now in DRS. But yeah, good wheel to wheel action there. Through sector 3. As Finus drops to 10 foot, but Finus is still got inside the line. I think HD was too far ahead there. So, good racing from these two lads.
Sorry, oh my god, Naughty Boy's just closed in on Remco now, again.
Yeah, I've just joined that as well, Malk.
Just watching this battle going on. Ooh, here we go, can he do it? Can he get DRS? Is this last corner? Can he do it? I think he might just get a bit close, or maybe he could do it. Banzai! Oh, that would have been bad. Oh, that would have been a bad banzai moment there.
Yeah, but with four laps to go, Malk, it's still all to play for.
I think, I don't know about you, but Naughty Boy went on the ride. I have to watch it again, I might be wrong, but the Remco just slowed down a little bit, unless it was the lag.
I've just joined HD in Facelift Reply. HD is now looking to take 8th place from Facelift Reply, but Furnish is closely falling behind as well, so Facelift Reply
three
could lose
bed.
Two positions here.
Three in a bed?
It's definitely three in a bed, it's definitely
oh,
three in a bed.
Oh, no, don't do this.
It looks as if Furnish might come out on top here, not, it just couldn't make that final pass on HD.
What a...
Sorry, yeah, just Oh, good racing, guys. Good racing.
We'll face Swift Reply on the inside line. Oof, jeez, Louise.
As we just come up to the final turn between Mordeboy and Remco, yellow flags are on track. DRS in a fit, I believe he is close enough to get it. Will Remco go defensive? Remco goes for the squeeze, and yeah, Mordeboy, that was a comfortable overtake with the DRS. But the question is, can Mordeboy hold on to second, hold off Remco for the final three laps?
That's the big question.
Yeah, definitely a good slipstream in in Spain. So allow Remco to close back up again.
Vanessen HDE, again, Ballina. Can we have another one of them?
So HD could come under threat here. He's closed right up behind HD. It's all about who gets a better exit, and can HD get a gap enough to try and protect himself from the DRS, or has Founis got the pace, got the DRS to get it done? Will he attempt the banzai? Possibly not this lap, but he will close right up behind him.
I'll tell you what, I'm kidding. After showing them with bonds, or.
Oh, Lucifer's! Contact! There's been contact! Lordy boys went off track, so there's been contact between him and Remco. It looks like Remco's just got the jump there and Josh, for some reason. Looked too easy. I'm just trying to catch it on the replay.
For some reason,
Josh had went wide, and Remco just eased past him. So there was contact earlier on, Lordy boys went off track, we cut to Remco and Josh, Josh went wide, while Remco had just come through easily. So, what has happened there?
I have no idea, because I just saw it the last minute, or sorry, last second of it, only when you shouted, with the collision going on.
Certainly that's a question I would like to pose to Josh, as to why you would allow a non-teammate to overtake you. It's easier than that, certainly for second place, because Josh was in second.
I think he, my personal opinion, I know I can't say without proof on that one, but I think there was a clash with me at some point, we've gone wide.
Yeah, but... If it was, I know I'm speculating as well. If there's been contact between Josh and Remco and Mordeboy, then Josh would have had to give in the place back to Mordeboy as well, because Josh was in fourth.
Yeah.
So if he's had contact and had to give the place back, he would have had to give it back to the two of them, and not just Remco.
Yeah.
So what's happened? Certainly it's a question I'd like to ask Josh after the race to see what happened.
Another battle, same battle with Fanison HDE again. Oh, Fanison's a gap. Can he go? Oh, I thought he was going to keep the inside line then.
Well, he's got one lap to go. Oh, can he get the move done?
He's got to do this.
He's close enough. He's got to do it. It's all or nothing.
It's going to say...
This is a difference between 2 points and 3 points, which could...
Oh!
He's went to the outside. Can he get the move done?
No, he can't.
But he will have the advantage of the inside the next turn, but HD will have the inside the next. Don't...
Well done, Big C.
Yeah, congratulations to Big C on the Spanish Grand Prix win. Sorry we didn't cut to you there, but there has been action elsewhere on track and we'd like to stay with that. Ewan has really closed up behind the battle between HD and Founis. Can he jump on this opportunity? That's right, Remco's got a 20-second penalty this race. So, Lordeboy should move up to third if he's able to maintain the 20-second gap.
There was quite a few.
I still don't understand the Remco's penalty.
Oh, Fanus is gone!
what's happened there is he just caught the curb. Honestly, I think that just...
That concludes
the nightmare that Fountains has had. I don't think he's had the best of races. The Sauber's just having their little fight. Can Aaron get the jump on HD at the end? Not HD, just moves along, covers him off. As Fountains comes in ninth. Yeah, I still don't understand. If Remco's got a 20-second penalty, why Josh would still let him pass. So, as we see, two Mercedes on the podium, but of course, Remco's 20-second penalty will apply as Big C takes a Spanish Grand Prix win.
Was the 20-second penalty before the seven laps?
It's going to be applied after the race result because of the instance in the Monaco Grand Prix.
Right,
we just have a quick glance at the instance for our race stewards or Kieran to look at.
Analyse.
And we'll see if there's any... Yeah, analyse, that's our milk. to see if there's any further penalties to be applied. Jake Warrior received a 10-second penalty for corner cutting. Naughty boy. But yeah, we do know that from last night's practice there is one corner where you almost straddle and you receive the 10 second penalty, but of course two wheels remain on track, so you're not really but there's also a 5-second penalty to Fountains for ignoring yellow flags, so I'm sure that will be
removed. Yeah. See? What would happen if I wasn't there with that penalty?
So I think the did Lordy Boy get it? I believe Lordy Boy finished 6 seconds behind Remco, so Lordy Boy will take third, Josh in second. Congratulations, Josh, great result. Big C will take the win.
Cool. Do you want to invite him and I'll accept?
It's up to you.
Because I don't think I've got any of the... I know I've got Big C.
I'll just have a check, see if I've got them.
Let me just see. Ah, players met. What? Should let me. I'll see if he's on. On mine. Yeah, he's.
Hello.
Hello? Which is just on.
I was a bit surprised. I messed up the qualifying slightly, made a mistake in the last sector, but a bit matter in the end. I was a bit surprised with Remco's pace. He was a lot slower than I thought he'd be, so it was a bit strange that I passed him quite comfortably and pulled the gap really quickly. So I was a bit surprised by that. But once the gap was there, I knew those guys were battling, and I went options after my first stop so I could pull the gap even more and ensured that I had an easy afternoon.
Yeah, because it looked as if you went for the three-stop strategy, but one on primes and three option runs, is that right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. It looked as if you stretched them out to about eight laps, so I'm wondering how comfortable it felt on those tyres nearing the end of that stint. Were you able to still put in the pace to open up a gap, or were you pretty much struggling at that time?
And I think the options were really good. I mean, my pace and the options were really consistent. The primes were not a good tyre. Like, they dropped off quite quick, considering they are meant to be the harder tyre, so they weren't that good, but as the most of the race was on the option anyway, it didn't matter too much. But Slaughty was on the primes when I was on the primes, so it was fine.
Yeah, but you definitely mentioned that you were surprised at Remco's race pace, I believe. It looked as if he wasn't carrying his quality pace, and certainly that was our opinion, because it looked in the race he was really struggling, and Lordy Boy, it looked as if you were pretty much almost primed to take over him at any time. It looked as if you were keeping up with him fairly easily. But one thing we noticed, Lordy Boy, that there was, I think we just missed the incident near the end of the race. What happened?
Well, obviously, he knew he had a 20-second time penalty, and if you can't race to win, race to spoil, to be honest. That's how I feel at this moment in time. Obviously, I'm going to have a look at the footage back and see what actually went on, but he was on the outside of a corner where it was impossible for him to overtake without me completely stopping the car. So he just needs to learn when to give up, to be honest, and that's coming from me. I always fight till the end, but he had nothing to gain from it. He knew he was going to get fourth place at the start of the race. So he clearly wanted to make a dent in my championship hopes. So he did.
You feel he was trying to deliberately sabotage your race by that move?
Well, obviously Bixi and Remco aren't the bestest of friends, but they're teammates for a reason. Obviously Bixi didn't have a say in it, of course. That's stupid for me to say. But he knows he messed up last race. And he knows he messed up Malaysia as well. So, you know, I had a perfect race in my opinion. You know, I was never expected to get the win. I made a post about it saying how slow I was compared to other drivers, but he wanted to make an impact and he surely did. That's all I've got to say.
So it sounds as if the mind games are in full effect in F2 then at the moment. Some are trying to use all tactics that they have at their disposal. But certainly the racing on track, I found it, again, another great race. Some great action to watch and commentate on. Congratulations, lads. Malcolm, wonder if you've got anything for them, for the guys?
I just want to say congratulations to all you guys for your podium finishes after the penalty, obviously, from Remco. Well done to Big C for the win. Did you think it would have been a closer race, or did you think not? Obviously not. But did you think beforehand it would have been a close race?
Yeah, obviously. I mean, after qualifying, I thought definitely be a good fight between us all, but it doesn't seem that to be the case. I'm not sure if it's what steps people are using or things like that, or they're practicing on time trial too much, they're not on GP mode. I don't know what the problem is, but I was genuinely surprised because, you know, Remco is usually really good in the race, but I'll speak to him later about it, but
yeah.
It was easier than expected, put it that way.
Okay, fair enough. I can't
Josh finished second. I don't, you not spoke to him yet. I don't know if you forgot that, so
I just want to say congratulations, Josh. Your qualifying time really impressed me, mate. It looks as if you've actually went up another gear in F2 and found almost another level in pace and, again, race pace. However, at the end, I almost saw Remco pass you. I believe it was in the second last lap when you went a little way going into the final turn.
I let him back through. I got an illegal overtake.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
So,
but
and
I kind of
he had a
joined that.
20-second time penalty, so I knew
Yeah,
that I
so
just
there's
defended it
nothing.
guys to
Okay,
it.
so there's nothing really to lose. But I'm wondering what your thoughts are on your Spanish Grand Prix and second position. I'm wondering what your thoughts are at this time.
I'm obviously delighted with second, first F2 podium, and it was handed to me a little bit because of Lordi's and Remco's crash. But I mean, I felt I kept the gap quite well to them, and my pace wasn't too bad. My quali, I could have done better. I could have got fourth, I think, but obviously fifth, I'll take. And yeah, overall, I think I did well, and I'm delighted with second.
Okay. Well, yeah, congratulations again. I'm wondering, with stepping up another gear, do you think you could possibly challenge for championships from next season or even this season? Do you think
Obviously,
that's
not this
possible?
season, I don't think. Not this season, and probably not in the short term, but I'm much less experienced, obviously, than all the others. And as Big C said before, he thinks I've got potential, so you never know. For me, I know I've improved a lot since I've been with Zai. So now, be challenging right at the top of F2. So, in the future, I do think maybe I could challenge for a championship, but right now I just need a first win, which obviously
So,
is.
just a quick question to Big C. As you were mentioning there, Josh, noticing Josh's potential, could that be a possible team lineup in the near future?
Potentially, I did sort of ask him at the start of the season, but he was already with Jake, so.
Get your hands off me, Josh.
No, Josh is a very good driver, and yeah, maybe we'll see. You never know how things go, but I think Josh would be a fantastic teammate. He's definitely very quick and improving continually, so best of luck to him.
Malcolm, wonder if you've got any points for the lads. I've pretty much asked everything that I wanted to ask him.
I just want to say well done to Josh for second place again, as what Greg's mentioned. Do you think you could get your first, well, you could get another win or your actual win in F2, try and beat Big C on that one, or not
It will
this
be hard,
season?
obviously, because Big C, Remco, and Lordi still have better pace than me at every track, I'd say. And Fanners, obviously, is quick. So it will be hard. But if I get a bit of luck out of my stronger tracks, I think I could maybe challenge for a win at some point. But I'm just aiming for podiums and points, obviously, in my first season. So
Yeah, I think,
I can't say.
yeah, you never know. One
Yeah,
collide, one
exactly.
anything, big luck in the draw, and that's it. You never know. You might get your next win.
Bit of luck I could, but it's unlikely.
Yeah, but you never know. It could have happened anywhere in any track. You just take it as a opportunity of a lifetime, mate, and that you'll get that. But well done anyway for second. Lordy boy, just one question, a couple of questions actually. Did you think you could get? I know. Forget to mention about the crash between, well, collide between you and Remco. But did you think third was your best opportunity, or did you think you could have got second on the race today?
At the start of the race, I was behind Remco, and I thought I was going to be further behind into turn one. I was quite forceful, I thought, into turn two, just to try and say to Josh, you're staying behind me. So,
I lost a couple of positions because of that, but it was all right.
Yeah.
Sweet.
I knew I had to stay with Remco, and I thought Remco, as Big C would say, would be closer to Big C. So I thought if I stick with Remco, I'll stick with Big C. Remco's got nothing to lose. He knows he's going to get fourth position if there was no crashes between any of us. But no, Big C, as soon as turn one and turn three, I think that was it. I had to get past Remco to at least get close to Big C because I thought Remco was quite slow actually on the day. And it just didn't work out because I knew he was gonna push me hard. I could tell. I think on lap six, I think I went for a bit of a bonsai move on the inside, and he did cut me up. And I knew then he was gonna be hard to pass. But no, I think second place, as soon as I got going, was definitely on the cards. I knew Josh would be right behind me if I did make a mistake on my own. So the Josh would have been right there. But no, if anyone else could have got second place, I'm happy it's Josh because he deserves it.
Fair comment. Fair comment.
You know, good pace from him. Been consistent. We've been matching each other, to be fair, all practice sessions and stuff, qualifying times and stuff like that. So, yeah, congratulations to obviously Josh Big C for beating me. I know it's not often it happens, but... no, but second was definitely on the cards. That's definitely on the card.
Fair enough. Fair play. Fair play, Lordy Boy. Fair comment. Can't say any more than that. Just a general question to you three. Nick's Race, do you think there'll be... It's just a general question. Anyone can answer. Do you think it'll be a different outcome? Or do you think it will be a similar outcome for like the race in general? Like,
Who wants to go first?
Anyone?
I'll go first.
Okay.
Yeah, Silverstone's one of our best tracks. And Remco's quite good round there, so... I can see it being similar to here. I'm not just saying that to be big-headed, but it is a good track for me over the recent years, so... I think it will be... I think in quality it will be close between me and Remco. In the race, it remains to be seen. But, yeah, I'm confident. I'm very confident for Silverstone.
Yeah. But do you think... I was going to say, from the race today, do you think it'll be similar in the race pace? Or, I know it's hard to say, but...
Yeah, I think the same sort of names were up there. Because me, Remco and Lordy have all been in the top three together. So, we'll be up there. I think Josh is probably a couple of tenths shy of us at the minute. So, I think he'll be there or thereabouts. So, Aaron was quite strong at Silverstone last season as well. And you never know about the others, so...
Yeah. Okay. Josh? Cool, thank you, Big C. Josh or Lordy Boy? One of you two.
Yeah, okay. I think it will be two Mercedes at the top. I'm not sure if it's Lordy's strongest track, so I think it'll be probably third, battling for third.
But, okay.
I think it'll be two Mercedes, but on race pace, from what I've seen today, I'd expect Big C to get it, but you never know, obviously. And Remco's very strong always. For me personally, I'll be aiming for around top five, fifth, fourth. I know Lordy will probably be quicker than me, and Irwin and Vanis are both quite strong, so...
Fair enough. Fair enough. Can't argue with that one. But it could rain, you never know, in Silverstone. It's good with bloody...
It's likely to rain.
Yeah, 100% guaranteed at Silverstone. Lordy Boy?
Like Josh said, I don't know if Silverstone's a strong track for me yet or not, because I don't think I've touched it on this game. Only, you know, at the start when you're getting used to the handling of the river pad and stuff.
We've not done it for the last two seasons or anything, but yeah.
Yeah, so we haven't touched the track at all. Honestly, I don't know. Remco, obviously, is going to be quick. He enjoys Silverstone. But I think Remco will be more competitive because he actually has something to race for next race. Yeah. So, no, I'll obviously try my hardest to try and keep with Big C, but I think Big C's one step ahead of everyone in terms of pace, to be honest.
Okay.
You know, he's just got that edge. I don't know if it's wheel hacks or the game's glitch, but, you know, you don't know. He's just one step ahead of everyone. That's why he's a four-time champion. So, it'll be interesting.
Fair enough. Fair enough. Thank you for that, guys. Have you got any more, Craig, or that's it?
No, I just want to ask the lads if there's any final comments that you would like to leave us with.
Yeah,
I'll say one little thing, if that's okay. Tej is the best league director we've had, so thank you, Tej.
I agree.
Yeah, thank you guys for your time as always. I look forward to rewatching it later.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Just going to say congratulations to Tom Dine on a great race as well. He got some good points, I think. I'm not sure exactly where he finished, but he was definitely high up because I came out behind him in the first stop, so he looked pretty quick. So congratulations to Timeline. But yeah, that's fine. I'll see you guys in a bit.
Thank you very much.
See you in a bit. Bye.
See you in a bit.
Thanks, lads.
Right. Where shall we start, Craig? On this F2... brilliant
I think
race.
Fairly strong words after that race.
Yes.
See what happens in the paddock posts and possibly in the races to come to see if there's maybe in the afters after that. So yeah, looking forward to see how the season develops. Also have to wait and see what happens for the steward's office. Just noticing a quick comment from Remco, believing that it was the side pod glitch that contributed to the incident between himself and Lordy Boy. So certainly differences of opinion there on the same incident. So we'll see. We'll see what happens if Lordy Boy decides to go any further with that decision.
Okay, because we...
Sorry, Mark.
Sorry. It was just a quick one. It was just because I think I didn't get caught on that until the aftermath of what happened. But I don't know if you got it caught at that point.
I completely missed it. I think I noticed a car off track. Jumped to see who it was. And it was Lordy Boy. So, you know, trying to make as much a conclusion with limited evidence
yes.
as if there had been an incident. Who with? I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, we obviously commentators.
We did clear up. Yeah, we did clear up the reason as to why Josh allowed Remco through. It was the illegal overtake.
Yeah. So that was our debate. Why did he do this? Why did he do that? but we found out the reason, and it was answered call on that.
Well, next week, you know, we're back at the home of British Motorsport, Silverstone.
Yes.
Some would say a firm favourites by most of our drivers here. It's not a track I really enjoy. I always find it quite tricky through Sector 2, but I'm sure that F2 will provide another great spectacle next week.
Yeah. Obviously, I know you said Josh was your, as opinion at the time during the race, was your driver of the day. Is he still your driver of the day?
Yeah, I would stick with Josh as driver of the day.
Cool.
I certainly think he deserves it. You know, he's definitely come on leaps and bounds. We almost expect Big C and Remco to be challenging for the wins. And now we're seeing Lordy Boy doing it with some great success. But yeah, very impressed with how quickly Josh has developed in F2. And he's definitely set a marker there that I assume he's hoping to improve on and inevitably get that first race win.
Definitely. I think he will. I reckon he will get it. But it's a matter of time because you don't know when Big C is about to stop, because I can't see it at all unless something dramatic happens in one of the races. But like Spain last year, where he got collided on the first corner and then he went right at the back battling out, and we've never seen him done that, but now it feels like he's just a machine. You just can't beat him at the minute. I don't know about you.
He's definitely in good form. Certainly high in confidence. I think he'll definitely continue it. I don't see anybody else really going up against him, to be honest with you. Unless, you know, Remco can find some more consistency to challenge him, but we'll see. There's a few races remaining, and we'll see what happens in the remaining races.
Yes, just a few things. What did you think of the comments from the drivers, like mind games? Do you think there were?
Certainly, yeah. Certainly, strong words. And we'll see how they play out. You know, it's. Anything to get in somebody's head and try and unsettle them, then, you know, I'm all for it.
Yeah. Well, that's what we do with F5, don't we, Craig? With the English versus
definitely.
Scottish. Don't worry, we'll have some harsh words afterwards on this one. But, it's been a pleasure as always, Craig, with this.
And same.
I know I come in late again, trying to get into the room, but I just couldn't get the first six laps and the quali from my stream, so anything from lap seven.
We got there and we certainly covered a fair amount of the action.
As like I said, as always, Craig, it's been a pleasure as always. And if you got any other last comments to the lovely viewers?
None at all, apart from, do you fancy a spin practice?
I certainly do, Mr. Craig. Thank you very
Okay,
much.
and we shall leave our viewers with that. We still have 13 viewers, so thank you very much for joining us tonight, and I
Thank
hope
you
you
all.
can join us for next week in Silverstone. So again, thank you. Hope you enjoy the show, and look forward to having you again with us next week.
Yes, definitely. Cheers for that, guys. See you later.